your devoted shout for joy. For the sake of David, your servant, do not reject your anointed.
Shepherd, you In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
We come here with great joy in our hearts as we are ordained 5 men to the priesthood for this archdiocese. And it is a joy that is deep-seated in our hearts as we have followed them in their years of formation. Welcome to all of you, especially all of the family members, the parents, friends, and those parishioners that have been a part of their lives. Let us allow the Lord's joy to run deep in our hearts this day, beginning with our own acknowledgement of God's mercy and forgiveness, but confident as well that He is rich in His mercy, abundant in His forgiveness.
You were sent to hear the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us all of our sins and bring us to life everlasting. Grant, in persevering obedience to your will, through these deacons of your church, whom you graciously choose today for the office of priesthood, so that by their ministry and life they may gain glory for you in Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Lectura del profeta Isaías. El Espíritu del Señor Yahvé está sobre mí. Sepan que Yahvé me ha ungido. Me ha enviado con un buen mensaje para los humildes, para sanar los corazones heridos, para anunciar a los desterrados su liberación y a los presos su vuelta a la luz, para publicar un año feliz lleno de los favores de Yahvé y el día del desquite de nuestro Dios. Me envió para consolar a los que lloran y darles a todos los afligidos de Sion una corona en vez de ceniza, el aceite de los días alegres, en lugar de ropa de luto, cantos de felicidad en vez de pesimismo. Les pondrán el sobrenombre de encinas de justicia, los que Yahvé plantó para su gloria, the word of the Lord.
Czytanie z Dziejów Apostolskich. Paweł, posławszy z Miletu do Efezu, wezwał starszych kościoła, a gdy do niego przybyli, przemówił do nich: uważajcie na samych siebie i na całe stado, nad którym Duch Święty ustanowił was biskupami, abyście kierowali kościołem Boga, który On nabył własną krwią. Wiem, że po moim odejściu wejdą między was wilki drapieżne, nie oszczędzając stada. Także spośród was samych powstaną ludzie, którzy głosić będą przewrotne nauki, aby pociągnąć za sobą uczniów. Dlatego czuwajcie, pamiętając, że przez 3 lata we dnie i w nocy nie przestawałem ze łzami upominać każdego z was. A teraz polecam was Bogu i słowu Jego łaski, władnemu zbudować i dać dziedzictwo ze wszystkimi świętymi. Po tych słowach upadł na kolana i modlił się razem ze wszystkimi. The word of the Lord.
Jesus went to all the towns and villages, teaching in their synagogues, proclaiming the gospel of the kingdom, and curing every disease and illness. At the sight of the crowds, his heart was moved with pity for them because they were troubled and abandoned, like sheep without a shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, "The harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. So ask the master of the harvest to send out laborers for his harvest." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise
Let those to be ordained priests come forward. Pavel Orlikowski. Dominic Michael Clementi, Jr. Miguel Angel Flores. Matthew Richard Attack. Michael Kenneth Trail. Most Reverend Father, Holy Mother Church asks you to ordain these, our brothers, to the responsibility of the priesthood.
Do you know them to be worthy?
After inquiry among the Christian people, and upon the recommendation of those responsible, I testify that they have been found worthy.
Relying on the help of the Lord God and our Savior, Jesus Christ, we choose these men, our brothers, for the order of the priesthood.
Thanks be to God.
Special greetings go to the parents, the families, and friends of those to be ordained. I know that some of you have traveled a long distance. We are blessed to have each and every one of you here today. As you heard, Father Carchi, the rector of our seminary, call the names Dominic, Matthew, Michael, Miguel, and Pavel. The names of your sons, your brothers, friends, prompting the response, thanks be to God, and the fulsome applause that followed. No doubt your own heart surged with joy and gratitude. For you know not only their names, but what they mean to you. Thank you for your support and for your love of them. You have been part of their formation, leading to this day. In fact, it is you, the parents, family, lifelong friends, classmates, who were the first formators of their vocations. Speaking to priests last November, Pope Francis urged them to recognize this truth and embrace their personal history. The priest, he said, is a man who is born in a certain human context. There he learns the primary values, absorbs the spirituality of the people, grows accustomed to relations. Priests also have a history. They are not mushrooms that suddenly appear in the cathedral on the day of their ordination. I'm sure the five of you are consoled to know that the successor of Peter doesn't consider you mushrooms. A good priest, the Pope goes on, is first of all a man with his own humanity, who knows his own history, with its riches and its wounds, and who has learned to make peace with this. My brothers, you have chosen readings that define your ministry in a number of ways that I want to address, three of them in particular. First, we hear that Jesus calls you harvesters, implying that the joy you will experience as a priest is found in the harvest time. It is the joy of the harvest time. Having lived and worked in rural areas for many years, I know the joy of harvest time. The rich gold and wheat fields of the fertile Palouse region of eastern Washington come to mind. There, the super abundant and booming yield per bushel is regularly some of the highest in the world. It's exhilarating to watch the combines carve around the hillsides, giving the impression the earth is getting a haircut. Yet the Word of God makes clear that the fields you are to harvest are marked not by healthy, prosperous, or vigorous growth, but by disease and illness. You are being sent not to where life is thriving and flourishing, but to the lowly, the brokenhearted, captives, mourners, those who are troubled, distressed, and abandoned. You are being sent where sometimes there is little joy and gladness. That is why you must bring it. St. John of the Cross once wrote, "If you go to a place where there is no love, put love there, and they will have it." Your joy and exhilaration will be in seeing the new life and the healing, the transformation that will take place as you offer comfort, as you set captives free, as you share good news and heal with the oil of gladness. Remember this as your hands are anointed with chrism. It is the oil of gladness, the pledge that the anointed one, Christ, is with you as you enter the harvest field. And knowing that he has sent you will be your joy, the joy that you will offer others. The power and the gift of language is a second feature of your ministry found in today's readings. You are to proclaim, announce, offer glad tidings. Last fall, in speaking to the U.S. bishops, Pope Francis urged us as pastors to seriously consider how we use language. If we are serious about promoting a culture of encounter, dialogue is our method, he said. The path ahead is dialogue, Pope Francis told us, adding, "I cannot ever tire of encouraging you to dialogue fearlessly. Dialogue aims at understanding. It thinks of others first and realizes that the brother or sister we wish to teach, to reach and redeem with the power and the closeness of love counts more than positions, distance as they may be from what we hold as true or certain." And the opposite is true, he says. Harsh and divisive language does not befit the tongue of a pastor. It has no place in his heart, although it may momentarily seem to win the day. Only the enduring allure of goodness and love remains truly convincing. And if a culture of encounter and dialogue is to be sustained in our ministry to the people of God, it must be fully alive first in our relationships with each other. As one presbyterate in this archdiocese who share in the same spirit and who work together, ever treasuring the peace that is given to us. Remember this as your brother priest join me in imposing hands for the gift of the Spirit upon you. Ever keep in mind that on the day of your ordination, as your brothers embraced and welcomed you to this presbyterate, their first word to you was peace. And as you, the faithful of this archdiocese, witness those very compelling signs of shared spirit and the gift of peace, let these actions remind you that Jesus' church is kept whole not by consuming fire from heaven, but by the secret warmth of the Spirit who heals what is wounded, bends what is rigid, strengthens what is crooked. Finally, your ministry is about praying for and attracting other laborers for this abundant harvest. What will be attractive to others is not the work that you do, how many long hours you put in, but the joy that you bring to it, the confidence you show that Christ is at work in you and all that you do, by the respectful and humble way you serve people and share life and ministry with your brother priest. There is a deep river of goodness in our young people. I have seen it in their concern for the poor, their generous service and volunteer efforts, the willingness to sacrifice for others. Equally, they have in their hearts a desire for solidarity and working with others for a common purpose. We need to pray this very morning that the Lord stir up in their hearts a generous spirit and a yearning for companionship to be laborers in the field. But we also need to help the Lord attract them by the way we together serve with gladness and friendship. Yes, today, let us offer a hopeful prayer to the Master of the Harvest that young men present here in this cathedral today will be attracted by the good they see in you. A prayer that they will be open to Christ's call to join us in the work of the harvest. These are some of the things the Word of God offers today as the Church ordains you five men priests as you enter this presbyterate. You are harvesters, anointed to bring the joy to the harvest. You are to anoint and proclaim in speech and action good news, commissioned to pray and work together in a way that assists the Lord to send yet even more laborers into the field. On Jesus' first day of public ministry, he cited the passage we have heard today from Isaiah the prophet. Like it was for him, we pray that already on this first day of your ministry, all of this will be fulfilled in our hearing. My brothers, before you enter the order of the priesthood, you must declare before the people your intentions to undertake this office. And so I ask you, do you resolve with the help of the Holy Spirit to discharge without fail the office of priesthood in the presbyteral rank as worthy fellow workers of the order of bishops in caring for the Lord's flock?
I do.
Do you resolve to exercise the ministry of the word worthily and wisely, preaching the gospel and teaching the Catholic faith?
I do.
Do you resolve to celebrate faithfully and reverently, in accord with the Church's tradition, the mysteries of Christ, especially the sacrifice of the Eucharist, the sacrament of reconciliation, for the glory of God and the sanctification of the Christian people?
I do.
Do you resolve to implore with us God's mercy upon the people entrusted to your care by observing the command to pray without ceasing? Do you resolve to be united more closely every day to Christ the High Priest, who offered himself for us to the Father as a pure sacrifice, and with him to consecrate yourselves to God for the salvation of all? Pavel, do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors? May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. Dominic, do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors? May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. Miguel, do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors? May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. Matthew, do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors? May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. Michael, do you promise respect and obedience to me and my successors? May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. My dear people, let us pray that God, the all-powerful Father, will pour out abundantly the gifts of heaven on these his servants, whom he has chosen for the office of priest.
Lord, have mercy.
sanctify these chosen men.
Hear us, we beseech you, Lord our God. Pour out on these servants of yours the blessing of the Holy Spirit and the power of priestly grace, that those whom in the sight of your mercy we offer to be consecrated may be surrounded by your rich and unfailing gifts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please stand.
Draw near, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, Author of human dignity. It is you who apportion all graces. Through you everything progresses. Through you all things are made to stand firm, to form a priestly people. You appoint ministers of Christ, your Son, by the power of the Holy Spirit, arranging them in different orders. Already in the earlier covenant, offices arose established through mystical rites. When you set Moses and Aaron over your people to govern and sanctify them, you chose men next in rank and dignity to accompany them and assist them in their task. So too, in the desert, you implanted the spirit of Moses in the hearts of 70 wise men, and with their help you ruled your people with greater ease. So also upon the sons of Aaron, you poured an abundant share of their father's plenty, that the number of the priests prescribed by the law might be sufficient for the sacrifices of the tabernacle, which were a shadow of the good things to come. But in these last days, Holy Father, you sent your Son into the world, Jesus, who is apostle and high priest of our confession. Through the Holy Spirit, he offered himself to you as a spotless victim and made his apostles, consecrated in the truth, sharers in his mission. You provided them also with companions to proclaim and carry out the work of salvation throughout the whole world. And now we beseech you, Lord, in our weakness, to grant us these helpers that we need to exercise the priesthood that comes from the apostles. Grant, we pray, Almighty Father, to these your servants the dignity of the priesthood. Renew deep within them the spirit of holiness. May they henceforth possess this office, which comes from you, O God, and is next in rank to the office of bishop. And by the example of their manner of life, may they instill right conduct. May they be worthy co-workers with our order, so that by their preaching and through the grace of the Holy Spirit, the words of the gospel may bear fruit in human hearts and reach even to the ends of the earth. Together with us, may they be faithful stewards of your mysteries, so that your people may be renewed in the waters of rebirth and nourished from your altar, so that sinners may be reconciled and the sick raised up. May they be joined with us, Lord, in imploring your mercy for the people entrusted to their care and for all the world. And so may the full number of nations gathered together in Christ be transformed into your one people and made perfect in your kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Thank you.
Lord Jesus Christ, whom the Father anointed with the Holy Spirit and power, guard and preserve him, that you may sanctify the Christian people and offer sacrifice to God. The Lord Jesus Christ, whom the Father anointed with the Holy Spirit and power, guard and preserve him, that you may sanctify the Christian people and offer sacrifice to God. The Lord Jesus Christ, whom the Father anointed with the Holy Spirit and power, guard and preserve him, that you may sanctify the Christian people and offer sacrifice to God. The Lord Jesus Christ, whom the Father anointed with the Holy Spirit and power, guard and preserve him, that you may sanctify the Christian people and offer sacrifice to God. The Lord Jesus Christ, whom the Father anointed with the Holy Spirit and power, guard and preserve you, that you may sanctify the Christian people and offer sacrifice to God. Father Michael, receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. Understand what you do, imitate what you celebrate, and conform your life to the mystery of the Lord's cross. Father Matthew, receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. Understand what you do. Imitate what you celebrate and conform your life to the mystery of the Lord's cross. Father Miguel, receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. Understand what you do, imitate what you celebrate, and conform your life to the mystery of the Lord's cross. Father Dominic, receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered by God. Understand what you do, imitate what you celebrate, and conform your life to the mystery of the Lord's cross. Father Pavel, receive the oblation of the holy people to be offered to God. Understand what you do. Imitate what you celebrate and conform your life to the mystery of the Lord's cross.
Eternal is merciful love. He is faithful.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, you have willed that your priests should minister at the holy altar and serve your people. Grant by the power of this sacrifice, we pray, that the labors of your servants may constantly please you, and in your church bear that fruit which lasts forever, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son high priest of the new and eternal covenant. And by your wondrous design, we're pleased to decree that this one priesthood should continue in the church. For Christ not only adorns with a royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with a brother's kindness, he also chooses men to become sharers in his sacred ministry through the laying on of hands. They are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your children the paschal banquet, to lead your holy people in charity, to nourish them with your word, and strengthen them with the sacraments. As they give up their lives for you and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as an exaltation we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, Graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of Christ, your Son, be filled with his Holy Spirit and become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Blase our Bishop, with the order of Bishop, this your servant, who has been ordained today as a minister for the church, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered through all the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, with him, in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Bring us to your lasting life. Thank you.
Let us pray. May the divine sacrifice we have offered and received, O Lord, give new life to your priest and to all your servants, that united to you in unfailing love, they may receive the grace of giving worthy service to your majesty. Through Christ our Lord.
Be seated for just a moment. I'd like to start with just one brief logistical note. Immediately at the conclusion of the liturgy, we ask that the immediate family members only, the immediate family members of the newly ordained, please come forward, remain here in the cathedral for first blessings from the newly ordained, and the stations of each one of the men can be found on the inside cover of the program. Yes, just maybe about 15 minutes afterwards, then all the other family and friends feel free to come in. And all of us are invited to a beautiful reception just through the doors on my right, out in the courtyard. We couldn't ask for a better day for that. I'd like to say that Mundelein Seminary is meant to be the spiritual heart of the diocese, but geographically we're way out on the perimeter. So today is a wonderful opportunity to come right into the heart of the city. But of course, the beautiful liturgy we've all just taken part in is the fruit of years and decades of formation that happens far beyond the walls of the seminary. So on behalf of the Archbishop, I'd just like to take this opportunity to thank some of the people who've been involved in the formation of these men and the beautiful liturgy that we celebrated. I'd like to thank the Knights of Columbus for, yes, the beautiful honor guard they provided with us today, but in so many ways, through their prayers and support, they help the men preparing for ordination. We were led in prayer today by the wonderful choir and music, Dr. Ricardo Ramirez, director of music here at Holy Name, Linda Sarabona, our own director of music out at Mundelein Seminary, the choirs and cantors from Holy Name, from the home parishes of our ordinands, and from parishes throughout the Archdiocese of Chicago, helping arrange all the seating and logistics of the cathedral today and all preparations leading up to it. As you can imagine, it's a huge task, and I want to thank the leadership in that provided by Father Marty Barnum, faculty at Mundelein, Kim O'Neill, our administrative assistants, Michelle Peltier, here at Holy Name. The director of liturgy, not only at Holy Name Cathedral, but also at Mundelein Seminary, is Father Brad Zamora. He's so good we had to use him twice. And we thank him for all the wonderful leadership he provides. The many lay faculty and staff members of Mundelein Seminary, as well as the priests of the faculty throughout the Archdiocese of Chicago, all the priests serving in parishes throughout the Archdiocese, internship pastors, who helped serve as mentors for our seminarians, Kevin Hayes, the rector of Casa Jesus, Father Yasuo Corona, the rector of Abramovich House, Father Peter Sneed, rector of St. Joseph College Seminary, and Father Francis Bitterman, vocation director for the Archdiocese of Chicago. Special note of thanks to all the auxiliary bishops who are the pastors for their respective vicariates. Very special thanks to echo what the Archbishop said to the families of the ordinands for all that you have done to help prepare these men for this day. We've all been hearing a lot about the call of Christ to us as an archdiocese to renew his church. So I'd like to thank in a special way the man who has led us in helping to understand what that vision is. We've all in this liturgy just taken part in a small representation of that, what that renewal will look like. But I'd like to thank you, Archbishop Cupich, for helping us realize that vision and carry it out.
Before the final blessing, I want to echo the sentiments of gratitude that Father Parchi spoke on my behalf, but I also wanted to make sure that we thank him personally for the wonderful leadership that he offers at Mundelein Seminary, and the way that he has also inspired the students, the faculty and staff in this first year of his as the rector. We're so very pleased and grateful that he said yes, and continue to pray for him and the success of the seminary. Thank you, Father Karchi. And finally, I think that it's worth drawing attention to the fact that there are those in our midst who shortly will be ordained to the priesthood for their own dioceses. And so we want to congratulate them, their classmates, of those newly ordained here. And so if you would stand, those of you who are going to be ordained in the near future. The Lord be with you.
Bow down for the blessing.
May God, who founded the church and guides her still, protect you constantly with his grace, that you may faithfully discharge the duties of the priesthood. May he make you servants and witnesses in the world to divine charity and truth, and faithful ministers of reconciliation. And may he make you true shepherds, to provide the living bread, the word of life to the faithful, that they may continue to grow in the unity of the body of Christ. And may Almighty God bless you, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.